And so he's saying, my hour is not come. And so all of a sudden, Mary steps aside. And he says, you know what? This is not about me. But whatever he asks you to do, do it. The working of the Holy Ghost, the working of miracles, is not about one person or more. It's about being submissive to what God wants. Really, it is miracles that come when we are submissive to what God asks us to do. And what a beautiful picture of Mary. She sees opportunity, but she steps back. Now, if her heart is being dealt with by God, I don't think Mary is this woman who's out of line. I don't feel that. I don't see him rebuking her in such a connotation. He just said, but I need to hear from God. I know my hour's come. She said, listen, whatever he asks you to do, I want you to do it. Whatever he says, do it. These are the last recorded words of Mary. She steps aside. The Bible says, and there were six water pots of stone after the manner of the purifying of the Jews. Now, these water pots weren't really things that they were going to get juice in. Understanding the water pots, they held, and I've read in a couple different places, some different things that they held anywhere from the low teens, even up to the 70s and 80s, of gallons of water. So these were large water pots. They held a great amount of water. Even the Jews today, when they go into their mosque, they will put this water through their nose and down their throat, and they'll spit it out. They do that three times, I believe, if I remember from what I read. And it was for the washing. It was cleansing of themselves. And so here it is, these water pots. There were six. What's that number stand for? Man. And so anything that man's involved in is always short of the number of God, seven. And so they're short why? They're short on what to do. Here it is, these water pots, they were for the purifying of the Jews. It was for the washing. And so, once again, depending on the size was how many gallons these were, and I'm not even... Why should I guess the gallons? I don't know. It's not important. But they were there for washing. That's what they were designed for. And so Jesus said to the servants, he said, fill the water pots with water. You know what? Jesus, your hour has come. He's about to do a miracle, Brother Justin. His hour has come. And so, and they filled them to the brim. Let's stop there. Do you want to see miracles from God? I do. Lots of people want to see miracles. And I don't say this as plain as I see it, but if God is going to do a miracle, it will never be upon the basis of the laziness of man. There is some responsibility to do what we can do and what he asks us to do. If you want to see a miracle, you've got to do what God asks you to do. The Word is full of all kinds of ways that you and I need to be living. And if our heart is given, not given to God, just given in the first place in our heart, but God wants all of our heart. Amen. He wants us to be obedient to Him. And as we are obedient, I believe that when we're not lazy in doing our part, we can anticipate a miracle from God. And so the Bible says that here were these servants, and they filled them to the brim. Listen, they did everything that they knew to do. They did what they knew was best. I'm not saying we need to try to do things in our own way, but I believe that until we see God work and move, we need to do it to the best of our ability, not half-hearted or halfway, but fill up to the brim and overflow. But it still was not enough. They needed God. Amen. The balance of what was left up to God to work and move. I'm me ask you tonight, what do you need or what are you expecting from God? Fill the vessel as full as you can. Our sufficiency is not enough. But when we've done all that we can do to the bread, it provides opportunity for God. The Bible says, and he said unto them, draw out now and bear to the governor of the feast. And they bear it out. When the ruler of the feast had tasted the water that was made wine and knew not whence it was, let's stop there. We know the story. He said, whoa, this is awesome. Not awesome that they're so intoxicated that now it doesn't matter what it tastes like. No. What it is they would bring out the best because you'd be so full that at the end you wouldn't really so much care about it being the best. But when you're really thirsty, but just 100, you got the best. And so the governor of the feast, he comes out and he's like, whoa, this is good. I don't even know where it came from. Think about that for a minute. I think I would rather be a servant knowing the working and the power of God than be a governor and not know the power and the working of the Savior. You hear me? Sometimes you may say, well, I want to be further. I wish I was more. Don't underestimate when you see the power of God and what God can do. How great it is to experience that than be the governor and not have a clue about what's going on. He knew it tasted good. What do you know about the work of Jesus? The Bible says, but the servants which drew the water, they knew. The governor didn't know, but the servants who did the work, they knew. And the governor called the feast, called the bridegroom, and he said unto them, every man at the beginning does set forth good wine, and when men have drunk, then that which is worse, but you have kept the good wine until now. Okay, I know I'm getting going on here right now. But let me just say something. The world loves to give the pleasure center that last season. They love to give the best at the beginning, and the worst is at the end. Can I tell you, serving God only gets better and better and better and better. There's good things. So Jesus was saying something in his miracle. When you taste of me, it only gets better. Child of God, be encouraged tonight. The things of God only gets better. The Bible says this beginning of miracles did Jesus in Canaan of Galilee and manifest forth his glory, and his disciples believed on him. Any of you ever see a miracle? Anyone ever remember that first miracle you really ever seen? Like, you can say, I can date that. I know, I can tell you the experience of the first miracle that I saw. Here's the first miracle. The Bible says that these disciples, their faith, their knowledge, their confidence grew in Jesus. God does miracles. So that our confidence can grow in Him. My first was that I really, really think of as a real divine miracle. I see a lot of things growing up. But for me, praying and warning prayer was my brother and his open heart surgery where they didn't give him good statistics in his chance of survival. But it came out perfect. We were just rejoicing and praising the Lord in that waiting room. Do you know why? Because we had seen a miracle. But now I carry that miracle in my heart as a pastor miracle about the church. I deal with people because I know God can do miracles. I walk the halls of Pinnacle Hospital knowing that God's able to do miracles because I've seen it. And I've seen more and more and more and more. Because it grows. That's what when God answers our prayer, that's what he does in us. He grows the faith in us. I'm going to finish up this chapter by just saying a few things. The Bible says that he went down to Capernaum with his mother and his brother and his disciples, and they continued there not many days. Now, we know that his brother obviously must have faith in him. He's following him. The disciples are following him. Did Jesus have sisters? Probably. Yeah. But they are married and in their own homes now. So they're not following. They have husbands and homes that they're tending to. So his mother, his brother, and the disciples follow him to Capernaum.
Mama.
That finishes up at least the first section here of chapter number 2. As I said, I'm trying to bring some dynamics out on Tuesday evening on the Gospel of John. Make it real to us. And hopefully I've said some things tonight that have kept your attention and has fed your soul and gives you good perspective. Anybody want to say anything? The Gospel of John or about John? I know that we look at this and look at things that are familiar and common in the Word of God to us. But it is my desire, yes, I will hopefully refresh the common, but it is my desire that I can take us at least to a deeper level. And you know what? There's probably even deeper levels than me, and I wish I could take you there. I want to take myself there. We'll study and do the best that we can do and ask the Holy Ghost to help us. And I believe he is. I'm enjoying this in John. Let it be a blessing to you. Amen. If nothing to say, let's stand tonight. Appreciate you being here. Let's be praying for our church members. Keep each other in prayer. Let's be praying for our services. Man, I'd love to see Tuesday nights grow bigger. Hey, Sunday nights, we've had visitors the past 2 Sunday nights. I'm encouraged by that. And hopefully folks will come back. They tell me they will. So we want to grow this thing. We want the kingdom of God to grow. We want Miracle Revival Church to just do exploits for God and grow the kingdom. Amen. I want to see people saved. I want to see them know more about the Word of God, taken to a deeper depth. Praise God. So I'm going to meet with the council as soon as church is over for a few minutes. Amen. Sister King, will you close us in prayer? Tuesday, so, well, yeah. What is that song? Almost there.